What's up, you guys? Josh Satya out here in Singapore, and thank you so much for joining me on the Night Owl Podcast. As always, you guys, I really appreciate all of you taking the time to listen in, whether it's on your commute, whether it's, you know, in your free time, whether it's, you know, at the end of the day because you're just trying to wind down or whatever. I really do appreciate it because it means the world to me. Now, as most of you know, I take all of my inspiration from life around me, from the people that I speak with, the TV shows, the movies, the songs, the lyrics, the memories that pop up on Facebook and Instagram and everything. So I just take it from everywhere, whatever seems relevant on the day itself, and I try to speak about those concepts. Now, today I really want to talk to you a little bit about the fact that even the best doctors cannot guarantee healing. There is no such thing as a guarantee for much of anything. I mean, except for the fact that all of us at one point are going to die. I can't even guarantee how you're going to die. I can't guarantee that it will be painless. I can't guarantee that you're not going to suffer anymore. I can't guarantee anything. Let's face it, I mean, even if you were to go to the doctor and find out, you know what, perhaps you have diabetes or high cholesterol, maybe you have a blood pressure issue that you need to take care of. Even if the doctor tells you, hey, you know what, this is affecting your health, it's shortening your lifespan, it's going to affect how much you can and can't do, what kind of energy you have, there is no guarantee that you're going to take that advice and do something about it. There's no guarantee that even if we prescribe certain medications to lower your blood pressure or your cholesterol, that it will actually work for your body. It's all trial and error. This is why they practice medicine. And the same thing goes for advice, practical advice, psychological advice, therapeutic advice, any of those things. Even a gym trainer can tell you. I can tell you from the best of my knowledge, this is the best way to rehabilitate a dislocated shoulder, okay? So that you have full range of motion eventually. But it depends on if that particular exercise aggravates your shoulder so much that you can't do it or not. It depends on how you hold the rest of your body. It depends on if you actually do the exercises when you're out of my sight, right? And it depends on if you're going to do anything that might re-injure yourself. There's a lot of variables out there, but the bottom line is no one can guarantee that there is a specific outcome for anything. I know plenty of business coaches out there that talk about, you know what, if you do this, this, and this, you're guaranteed to get this many followers in a certain amount of time. Okay, great. But there are some people who will do exactly what you said, but because of their type of business or their type of account or their kind of content, it doesn't quite work because it is created generically for a specific kind of business. Maybe it's only businesses that have services, not products. Maybe it's only businesses that can make house calls and not online classes. Maybe it's, there are so many variables, but what I'm trying to tell you is there are no guarantees. When it comes to my practice and the way that I teach my clients, there is no guarantee that my advice is going to help you. I can only help you troubleshoot as much as you're willing to tell me the truth. And I can't even check you or, you know, dig into whether or not you're telling me the whole truth and nothing but the truth, because I have to take at face value what you're telling me. I have to trust you for what your perspective happens to be. Now, eventually there may be situations where I ask you for more details or to introduce another person into our conversations, because maybe I need to hear from the other person as well so I can really figure out what the problem is. But even then, no matter what I tell you, you are still going to do what you want to do. I've had so many times that I have sat in a room with somebody and spoken to them. They're like, yeah, you know what? I understand. Yes, I need to take a step back. I need to ask for what I want. I need to draw boundaries, blah, blah, blah. And then I will feel so much better. I know it'll work. Logically, it makes sense. I got it. I know. And then when they leave the room that we happen to be sitting in, they go back to their regular lives. They fall back into the same old patterns, or they don't want to change because they like who they are when they're with this person. It's just that sometimes they hurt them and sometimes they don't, but they're not ready to let go of the things that are harming them yet. Bottom line, I can give you great advice. I can give you solutions. I can, you know, work through your whole trial and error process where I tell you, try this, and you tell me, yeah, it didn't work. This is what happened instead. And we keep on picking out other possibilities of how we could solve your problem. And eventually, it becomes a question of, are you going to do what I'm asking you to do the way that I'm asking you to do it, or are you going to do it your way? I've had so many times where people will say, oh my gosh, I can't paint for peanuts. And I could tell you how the brushstroke should be from left to right, how high off the, you know, the canvas, or what colors to mix, all of that stuff. But if you insist on doing it your way, like your version of what I'm telling you, it's not going to end up the way that you want it to. Or if you've omitted some details and I didn't know to consider those things when I was giving you the advice, it could backfire. The problem is, it's not something I can guarantee. What I can guarantee, though, is I'm here to support you. I'm here to help you along the way. I'm here to listen to whatever it is that you've got going on in your head. I'm here to hear you out when you want to vent, when you want to cry, when you want to throw things and just let loose. If you want to write down 1,000 times, you know, what exactly the problem is, I can help you and sit with you as you do those things. But at some point, you're going to have to get up and pick up the pieces and look at what it is that you have in your hands and decide for yourself, well, how much is this am I responsible for? And how much of this do I affect with my attitude, with my behavior, with my words? And what am I willing to change so that I can actually get a different outcome? Because trust me, most of the time when people come to me, they're at their wits' end, they're at rock bottom, they don't want to try what they've been trying anymore. They really are desperate for a different angle, for a different perspective, a different kind of solution, something they haven't thought of before. And usually, it doesn't involve understanding what the other person in their life is going through, the one that's causing them so much drama. But even then, I could write out a prescription for you, I could diagnose you, I could tell you exactly what's wrong, where, and where. I can help you energy test the food in your life, I could help you do all kinds of stuff. But at the end of the day, if you don't apply it, if you don't have that intention in your heart that you want this to be solved, it's not going to happen. I can't guarantee it. Neither can you. You can guarantee that you're going to give it a shot, but you don't know what that end result is going to look like because it involves somebody else. But this is the part I need you to let go of. If you're going to somebody expecting an apology and you do all the right things and say all the right things and they still don't give you an apology, that isn't a reflection of you. That is a reflection of them. If you apologize first because you feel like, okay, well, you know what? I had a part in this. It takes two hands to clap. I'll own my part. I'm going to apologize for my part. And they don't apologize as well in response. You have to be okay with the fact that, you know what? They just needed to hear you say it. But you've done the right thing by acknowledging your part in this and you've absolved yourself of some of those, that pain that you may have caused. But if they don't apologize right away or respond in kind, you've got to be able to let that go, that expectation go. Part of the healing is not about proving the other person wrong. Part of the healing is accepting that, you know what, I've owned all of my stuff and I have opened up and let people know that, yeah, I do have stuff and I'm not good at some stuff. And once you own that part of you, no one else can hold it against you ever again. Because you know about it. You've acknowledged it. It's not something you hide. It's not something you're ashamed of. It's not something you're guilty about. But the next part of that is you've got to be able to let go of that expectation that they will respond the way you want them to. They're going to respond the way they feel like. And that's okay. It doesn't reflect on you. It doesn't make you automatically a bad person because they didn't apologize. It makes them still hurt. It makes them a person who is still finding suffering in all of this or is not able or not ready to witness or acknowledge the parts that they play in the drama that happens to be a part of your life. And that's okay. You are only responsible for yourself, your thoughts, your beliefs, your actions, your words. That's all. And trust me, that's plenty. And once you learn to be the person that you've always wanted to be, you've aligned yourself with your principles, your values, and you feel good about the way you handle things, nothing and no one can take that from you unless you let them. So as much as I would like to guarantee that I can solve all your problems, I can't. I really can't. I can guarantee that I will not stop until I try and find anything and everything that might be helpful to you. That may be different mediums or modes of therapy. It could be, you know, CBT. It could be NLP. It could be any one of 1,000 different, you know, abbreviations or letters that stand for something. But the point is, I will not rest until you find a way to feel better about the situation. That part I can guarantee because that is controlling my own actions and beliefs and thoughts and words. But ultimately, the healing lies with you. I cannot lay hands on you and heal you. I can tell you what you need to know. I can show you what you're missing when you see the situation. And after that, it's about you understanding what you need to do next, healing the parts of you that shy away from any of those things that make you feel uncomfortable or scared, but in an effort not to be stuck because you're uncomfortable or scared ever again. So as much as I would like to confirm and guarantee, I can't, because the work is in your hands. I can open your mind. I can show you where to look. I can teach you a couple of new things. I can help you try out different strategies. But outside of that, it's up to you. And trust me, I know you can do it. So if you have any questions or concerns, drop them in the comments below. I do want to hear from you. And in the meantime, you guys, stop thinking that healing is this big, crazy, scary thing. It's not. Yes, you have to face the darkness. You have to face some of the mistakes you've made. You have to acknowledge it to yourself. You don't have to go shout it from the rooftops. But once you acknowledge what you've done wrong, you have somewhere to start from. You know where you can make yourself better. If you know that you can't make a free throw, you have to go back through the basics and figure out if your form is perfected. If you have any kind of vision issues that might prevent you from making the basket from, you know, the free throw line. And then it's a matter of practice. Practice, practice, practice until you can't get it wrong. Until it's second nature for you to make that shot. And it's the same thing with human relations and dealing with conflict. The first time you do something different than you've always done, the people that are involved, the characters in your particular drama, are going to be offended or affected somehow. And it's going to take them a little while to kind of understand what's going on, that you've actually changed and that they might be something that they need to adapt to. But eventually, if you continue that same route and you continue employing, you know, ideas and strategies that uplift you and make you a happier, healthier person, eventually they will have no choice but to adjust. Because you've changed, they can't be themselves the way they were before for much longer. You have influenced your environment, and that is a good thing. So I hope this helps. I hope you understand what I mean by there are no guarantees. Because no matter what I tell you, you're going to go do what you want to do anyway. If I tell you not to call that person, to cut them out of your life, and they suddenly call you, you still have a choice whether you answer or not. And that's on you. I can't tell you what you can and can't do after that. That's totally on you. I hope you understand. I love you guys, and I'll catch you again soon. Bye.